Good evening, humans. Tyrannosaurusmoth here, and tonight we're taking a look at the Plunderlings Drench Koral figure from Lone Coconut. This has been a really fun line, and I believe the Drench figures were originally supposed to be a stretch goal for the Kickstarter that didn't fund. However, they end up doing this through Big Bad Toy Store, and I think that's kind of how they made it work. And definitely happy to see that because I love translucent plastic, and this is kind of a goblin ninja sort of deal. Love it. So yeah, let's get right in this review. Let's do this. Aesthetically speaking, Koral here looks absolutely fabulous, and this is just further proof that Lone Coconut has really mastered the whole art of taking a basic buck and changing some key factors to make it seem or like look and become a different character or variation, etc. And you know, that starts with the absolutely delicious translucent plastic that they cast this in, just this wonderful shade of pink. That just looks great and is super, super clear all around. You can see all the joints there. Some might find that off-putting. I think it's really cool to see. I mean, I love seeing the way a figure actually works because it makes me feel better about articulating that, if that makes any sense. But that being said, the only paint on here is the eyes and teeth. And that's true with the other alternate heads, which we'll get into in the next section. Oh, and you can see the magnet on top of the head. Which we'll get into a little bit in accessories. But other than that, just looks really great. And the only other real change is the ears have these kind of webbed look, as you can see. Got a little imperfection there I didn't notice before, but that is what it is. But again, doesn't take away any from the figure. And then you have webbed feet. And yeah, those look really cool, very frog-like. And yeah, just very fun looking and just beautiful figure, especially on the shelf. As we have come to expect from the Plunderlings line, we get some crazy, adorable and fun accessories to go along with every figure. And Koral here is no different. So starting with hands, we get a couple of gripping hands right out of the box. And then we get, And then we get a couple of just kind of splayed out posed hands, which is very, very nice. And then we get three different heads. So right out of the box, we get that kind of closed mouth grimace. Looks very mischievous. They all look mischievous, honestly. And yeah, so we got that, just paint on the eyes and teeth, as I had pointed out before. Then we get a slightly more intense grimace. We got the teeth bearing. Again, same sculpt, just looks very, very, very nice. That beautiful translucent plastic. And then finally, we get the grimace with the mouth slightly open. And yeah, just all looks absolutely fantastic. Magnet in each head. And then we move on to the actual accessories. So we get a little bit of a hat, kind of a lily pad with a flower on it. As you can see, there's a magnet there, and that just attaches right over the heads. Doesn't go anywhere. Turn upside down because of that magnet, which is always a nice touch. And I love that they just allowed for one eye to come out of it. And then the other part of that head accessory is a little seaweed mask, which is completely adorable. Great sculpt all around. As you can see, there's a little notch for the ears right there. And that just attaches by coming up from the bottom. And as you can see, it just kind of holds on by the actual kind of plastic itself. So if you shake it too much, it will definitely come off, but the little hat actually helps keep that on. So worth noting. So there's that. And then we get this piece, which is kind of a little bit of a turtle shell. And from the promo pictures, pardon me, I understand that this is a backpack. However, I don't know how to get that on. Clearly you have to remove the arms to some degree. And I'm a little too afraid to do that. It didn't happen easily, so I wasn't gonna push the issue. But some great paint here with the little bits of seaweed binding. Then on the little like straps here made out of some sort of reed or twine. And then we got the turtle shell itself. All the spikes are in that nice yellow paint, and then a darker brown, which comes this lighter brown on the edge. Just really nice, very dynamic looking. So I've just been using it as a shield, which obviously you can do by slipping it over the hand, but it is supposed to be a backpack. So if you are braver than me, and certainly if you keep that up enough, I'm sure the arms just come right off. And then finally, we get the spear, which again, kind of a like kind of bamboo piece with some seaweed wrapped around here at the grip. And then just a little bit more to get those three prongs, which have that kind of lighter tan sort of whitish look at the very, very end of it. So yeah, it's really well done. So that is accessories. Being based off that same buck, if you are familiar with the Plunderlings at all, you know what to expect. However, if you're not, we're still gonna break that down right now. So starting off, we get a ball hinge at the head. So we're going to look down about that far. We're gonna look up, get the full range here all the way. It's absolutely beautiful. And you can see the range there, especially again with the translucent plastic, it's a little bit easier to see all the articulation just pretty much from any angle, which is great. You get just tons and tons of tilt, which is great. You don't always see that with a ball hinge. So always, always welcome. We come into our T-pose. We don't have a bicep swivel. We do swivel there at the shoulder, but we have a single jointed elbow that comes right to about 90 and we get some swivel there. Then we come to the hands, which are our hinge and swivel. So we get for the gripping hands vertical, and then we get horizontal for the other kind of posed hands. We come to the diaphragm and we do have a ball joint, as you can see. And that brings us all the way around. So we're crunching about that far forward, about that far back. And of course, we're gonna get some side to side there as well. Nothing at the waist. However, when you come to the hips, we get almost full splits. Again, kind of work those legs around. You'll get different, as you can see, kind of the right ones go a little bit further than the left right now, but work with it and you'll get different poses. Then we get thigh swivel right there. We get double jointed knees, bring us completely in half, absolutely great. Nothing in the shin, there's not really room for it, but we get beautiful, beautiful point, some decent forward, just kind of the slightest bit, and then some insane pivot slash rocker. So that's articulation. Getting a size comparisons, here is Coral with Fawn Grotto and a Jack Specific Mechasonic with some Hasbro, with some imports, with some monsters. Finally, with an Articulated Icons Oni and yours truly in human form as an Articulated Icons Ninja. So my final thoughts on the Plunderlings Drench Koral figure from Loam Coconut is that, you know, this is an absolutely adorable and super fun figure. And if this seems like your thing, you should absolutely pick it up. And additionally, I think, you know, this is actually a pretty good introduction to the Plunderlings line, because without all the like hand painted parts, it's a little bit easier to handle. All I have to go off is the Fawn Grotto, but I mean, I've definitely found this one a little bit easier to pose and stuff like that. I didn't have to heat it up at first. So I think it's a great introduction. So if you have any curiosity about this line, get one of the Drench figures. Cause they're absolutely fantastic. So that being said, I'll put links in the description below. This is a Big Bad Toy Store shared exclusive, so it's exclusive to both Big Bad Toy Store and Loam Coconut's Kickstarter for the product. So I will put both of those links in the description below, so please check those out if you are interested. And beyond that, I hope you found this review entertaining and somewhat informative, or actually flip that. So if you did, please consider liking, commenting, subscribing, and or sharing. And beyond that, if you want to take it a step further to help the channel even more, I'll have ways listed in the description below as well. So please, please, please check those out. And all that being said, ultra thanks to you one last time for watching, and I hope you take care of yourself, take care of those around you, and most importantly, stay weird, simians.